This would destroy the International Space Station forever. Space is finally becoming a homeowner's market, with big tech, defense, and finance players increasingly defending their turf in low Earth orbit. In exploring space, the International Space Station is an important component. It has played a significant role in research and development, giving scientists and astronauts worldwide a window into the workings of the cosmos. However, what if the ISS were to suffer a catastrophe? Would our space program still exist? This video examines some possible occurrences and collisions that could lead to the ISS's demise. Since 1998, a sizable orbital laboratory called the International Space Station, ISS, has existed in space. It has aided numerous scientific projects and is currently the largest object in space. Throughout its history, there have been several collisions involving the space station. One of the most crucial locations in space exploration has been the International Space Station for more than 20 years. However, this does not imply that it is unbreakable. Moreover, in this video, I will demonstrate how an asteroid or meteor collision could wipe out the International Space Station. Before we proceed, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more content. In order to subscribe to new video alerts, click the bell symbol. Have you already put it into action? Let's continue. What is ISS? The International Space Station is a sizable spacecraft. It moves around the planet. It's a residence used by astronauts. A science lab is located on the space station. To build it, numerous nations collaborated. Additionally, they collaborate to use it. The space station is composed of numerous parts. Astronauts put these pieces together while they were in space. The space station's orbit is 250 miles or so above the planet. NASA uses the station to study how to live and operate in space. These insights will aid NASA's space exploration. The age of the space station. In 1998, the initial component of the International Space Station was launched. That component was launched by a Russian rocket. Later, more parts were included. The station was opened to the public 2 years later. November 2, 2000, saw the arrival of the initial personnel. Since then, people have resided in the space station. More components have been added throughout time. In 2011, the space station was completed by NASA and its international partners. Size of the space station. The interior of the space station is the size of a 5-bedroom house. It contains a gym, 2 baths, and a sizable bay window. There is space for 6 persons to reside. It's nearly 1 million pounds in weight. The end zones and all of a football pitch may fit under it. The United States, Russia, Japan, and Europe all have science labs there. What components make up the space station? Many components make up the space station. The components are known as modules. The first modules contained the components needed to operate the space station. These modules also housed astronauts. Nodes, which are modules, link several station components together. Astronauts can do research in the labs on the space station. The space station has solar panels on its sides. These arrays harness solar energy. They convert solar energy into electricity. Arms for robots are mounted outside. The space station was constructed with the aid of robot arms. They can also direct science projects and move astronauts outside. On the space station, airlocks resemble doors. Astronauts utilize them during spacewalks. Docking ports resemble doors as well. Visitor spacecraft can connect to the space station using the ports. New crew members and guests arrive at the station through the docking ports. On the Russian Soyuz, astronauts travel to the space station. To get supplies onto the station, the crew members use the ports. Objective of the issue. With the help of the ISS and 5 separate space agencies, humanity has made significant scientific and collaborative advancements: US, Russia, Europe, Canada, and Japan. The many components of the ISS were created gradually by numerous nations, only coming into contact in orbit for the first time. As the largest artificial object in orbit, the enormous composite structure is now as long as a football field. As it completes its 16 daily orbits, passing 400 kilometers, 250 miles above the Earth's surface, it's visible to the naked eye from Earth. In the past 10 years, research conducted in the ISS's microgravity environment has led to advancements in vaccine development, medication discovery, and medical therapies. The ISS also aids in the real-time monitoring of Earth's ecosystems and natural calamities. It's used to test upcoming spacecraft technologies and research the health impacts of prolonged spaceflight in preparation for future human solar system exploration. The onboard research is progressing, although NASA has observed infrastructural and component slowdown. The ISS freezes on one side and receives solar radiation burns on the opposite side of each orbit around the Earth. These thermal extremes cause the material to expand and contract cyclically, which wears it down. Repeated docking and undocking result in slow structural degeneration, which eventually results in the station's mortality. Space radiation chars the transparent glass on the solar cells that power the station. There is also an unintended and catastrophic devastation risk due to the increased flying space debris. The ISS crew went into excavation standby when Russia destroyed a dead satellite with a missile, sending hundreds of bits of debris flying by the station at 5 kilometers per second, 3 miles per second. In 2016, a flyaway particle of paint cracked a window. However, according to NASA, high confidence exists the station will last until 2030. Potential threats to the ISS. The space debris threat. Space debris is the term for the tiny natural and artificial solid masses that continue to orbit the Earth in low Earth orbit, LEO. They range from a few micrometers to many inches across in size. More than 100 million micrometer-sized particles of debris, 100 million pieces measuring 1 millimeter or larger, 500,000 marble-sized chunks, 1 centimeter, and 23,000 softball-sized pieces are thought to be in orbit around the Earth. These parts move at 15,700 miles per hour, 25,266.7 kilometers per hour. An AK-47's muzzle velocity is approximately 1,588 miles per hour, 2,555.6 kilometers per hour, and its bullets have a 7.62 millimeter diameter. Thus, it is evident that satellites and the people who live on them are endangered by space junk. Donald J. Kessler, a NASA scientist, predicted in 1978 that after a critical level of debris concentration in LEO, another collision would cause a cascading effect, resulting in exponentially more debris being created, ultimately rendering LEOs completely unusable and unavailable for orbiting spacecraft. Debris protection in space. Due to the hundreds of millions of bits of space debris, it's hard to protect against them completely. The majority are too small to be monitored. NASA monitors objects that are 10 centimeters and larger because their increased size makes it possible to measure and watch them. Depending on the size and velocity of the projectile, there are three threat levels. The safety precautions range from collision shields that deflect the impact of smaller, less harmful items to orbital maneuvering for massive objects larger than 10 centimeters in size, measuring smaller than 1 centimeter. Maneuvers in orbit. An intentional altercation in a satellite's trajectory to prevent a collision is called orbital maneuvering. Assuming the satellite has them, turning off the rocket boosters is the simplest method to put this into practice. A 30-mile, 2.5-mile grid is drawn and orbits specifically for the ISS, with the spacecraft at its center. 10 centimeters and larger objects have their trajectories recorded and plotted. A debris avoidance maneuver starts if the object enters the ISS's spatial grid. It is determined whether a collision will occur. A maneuver is started if the chance is greater than 1 to 100,000, but only if it does not compromise the mission's goal. A maneuver is started if the chance is greater than 1 to 10,000, unless doing so increases the threat to the crew. The thrusters activate to provide the space station enough kinetic energy to evade the object in its near space. Re-entry movements to the initial orbit are started after the object has passed. Whipple defense. A Whipple shield, as its name suggests, is a physical barrier that guards against debris collisions with objects 1 centimeter or smaller. The shield carries Fred Whipple's name, who created it. It's a two-stage defense mechanism. The first is an aluminum alloy bumper shield, 0.26 centimeters thick and placed in space. Any collision is largely absorbed by it, which causes the thing to shatter into even smaller bits. The second stage is the spaceship wall, which is intended to withstand any contact with substantially weaker particles. The standoff distance, 10.2 centimeters, is between the bumper shield and the spaceship wall. Shield of Whipple stuffed. The prior shield concept included a stuffing layer between the outermost layer and the innermost spaceship wall. This is a straightforward improvement over that design. Aluminum alloys and a 0.15 centimeter thick coating on the outermost bumper. The stuffing and the farthest bumper from it are separated by 5.1 centimeters. Two layers of filling make up the material. An outermost shield-facing ceramic layer is followed by a polymer with appropriate tensile characteristics, such as Kevlar. Again, separated by 5.1 centimeters, the stuffing layer is followed by the spaceship wall. It's excellent if there are two layers before the spacecraft wall because this greatly reduces the possibility of coming into contact with the spacecraft. Whipple mesh shield. Aluminum mesh or very tiny crisscrossed aluminum fibers make the outermost layer of this design, as the name implies. This layer absorbs the initial impact and splits the debris into smaller particles, which are then prevented by the stuffing layer behind. A multi-stage system for debris protection is created to accommodate various objects based on their potential for damage. The orbital maneuver is the best strategy for large particles, greater than 10 centimeters. The next step for mid-sized particles relies on how easily they can be found. If they are discovered early enough, an orbital maneuver is started based on the likelihood of a collision and the achievement of the mission goals. Collision shields of various structures and designs are used, depending on the region they protect and their likelihood of a collision in orbit. If they are not detected, they are too small to pose a deadly threat to the spacecraft. There is no denying the importance of the International Space Station to humanity. It contributes significantly to global satellite communication, temperate control, and astronaut training, offering priceless research possibilities and training for astronauts. The ISS could still be destroyed despite having all of its capabilities for various reasons. Today's video has come to an end. Give the channel a thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Remember to click the bell symbol to receive notifications when new videos are posted. I will see you in the next video. Until then, bye.